Alright, it's Brew Day here at Argilla's, and I'm Steve.
Here. Big today. Got some all the yellow powders in there and everything. That's where you get all the hop flavors and aromas from all the hops. Comes from that lupulin powder. It's nice and fresh. That's where you get some different notes from the hops. A lot of grassy notes. Just things you can't get throughout the rest of the year. These are as fresh as can be right here. So we're going to throw them in at the end of the boil. Let it pick up all that flavors and smells and move right into the fermentation tank. Poles here and then we run there over to like the side of my house. So it was like a hop canopy in the backyard. It looked pretty nice.
That's cool.
That's back when we used to have visitors to our house and parties when we do that shit.
Oh yeah.
We have a party here every night. I don't know.
Understand that, man.
But when I was home growing, we used to brew the beers, and then everybody would come over and make pizza and drink the beers. Now we do it every day.
That's right.
Showing up on there.
There it is.
All the good stuff. There you go. It's all the glands and everything in there.
Invite everybody. People used to bring their friends, people from the neighborhood, all kinds of people just used to show up and drink beer and eat pizza. Doesn't take a whole lot to get people to come out and say
beer and pizza.
Yeah. It was fun though. We used to have fun doing that.
I guess that's maybe 3 ounces, 4 ounces maybe.
Slow down so we're not, because it comes
firing out if you have it full bore.
Right.
So we can slow this down so we get a nice calm recirc. Because what we're trying to do is clear the mash. So, so if we're agitating it, that's defeating the purpose of what we're doing with this. And then we've got this here too for when we start to sparge. We can regulate the amount of sparge water that's coming out through the sparge arm.
Yeah.
And then I've got another one because when it's running across here, these don't work so well. These valves right here, as far as like, unless they're fully open.
Okay.
You try to half it or whatever, it just doesn't work well. These ball valves here work a lot better.
Awesome.
So I got one there too that we put on, that we can slow down the runoff in there, because that way you give it more time to fully extract the sugars out of the grain. You get a better efficiency. There it is. Mm-hmm. Better efficiency.
We want to bring this water up to this. As far as what we want to bring it up to about 180.
Okay.
So we'll let that run until we get to 180. And then the main thing too, you gotta remember on this pump now, when it ran off in, when you're running that water in, this is the outside, right? You see it says out right there?
Yeah.
So then when we're recircing, we want to flip it around so that that's coming and the out is pushing it back up to the top.
Gotcha.
Right? So we gotta just flip the pump around here. I'm surprised it's that goddamn hot. Reading about 147, but I was hoping to be around 145, really, and wait for the research.
So they call this the hot liquor tank. Why do they call it liquor?
That's just what they call the hot water. Call it liquor. Okay. I don't know why.
Yeah.
I'm sure there's some old reason as to why, but that's just liquor just means water.
Gotcha. Okay.
Yeah, HLT, whatever you want to call it.
Yeah.
We'll have a day soon too where we take all this down.
Yeah.
Wipe all this kind of white film off of here and spray it with some high temperature spray paint.
Yeah.
That stuff works pretty good.
Yeah.
Today actually probably would have been a good day to do it since we're going to be closed till 6. Because, spray paint in here.
Yeah.
It's not ideal. Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, you gotta wait for that to dry before you turn those on.
Yeah, right, exactly. Yeah.
Yeah,
so we have to do it on a day where we got a couple of days off.
Right.
But it'll make it look pretty. So we gotta spray it again.
Right. I forgot we just inhaled all of that. All of those grains, all that grain.
Yeah, right, yeah. Yeah, that helps sneeze too. I guess at the end of the day today, I'll just fill this up with some hot water and PBW and let that sit for a while and go on and kind of break everything apart in there. But it's hard to get down to the bottom of this thing. We don't have a CIP system, which I would like to get.
Right.
But we're here brewing. As you can see, it's a little hot in here. Just mashed in for our fresh hot beer today. And I just wanted to give a mention too to keep your eyes peeled for a another podcast we may be doing, A Tale of Two Brewers, where we try to hook up some local brewers around the state, talk to them, find out their story, and some of the trials and tribulations they had along the way. So keep your eyes peeled for that.
Thank you.
what's in these bags. Steve, how you like this part, man?
It's my favorite part, man. It's a good workout, that's for sure.
Especially in this heat.
Yeah, this summer, that's the best part. How did they have a summer, baby? What better time to do a nice big batch of beer?
Day, one of my favorite beers to do is fresh hop beer. Only one time a year that you can do it, so it's always fun to get them in and see what you get every year. It's different every time too, so it was a lot of fun, and now it's the best part is to get to enjoy what we've been working so hard on. Cheers.
Cheers.